yet here again to give the usual quarterly briefing. I would like to start by asking how many people know this book apart from managers? No, then you are betraying them because they are supposed to discuss with you. So this is the new strategic plan, 2018 to 2022. It will form the basis of everything that we do for the next 5 years. So any conversation we have about the health of the hospital and how it is doing will be based on this script. So after the Bible, this should be your closest book that is closest to you. There's a soft copy version, so I am sure you are in various groups with your managers, with your departments. It can be circulated to you. And if you really need a hard copy, you can also come to our office, the executive director's office. And Pamela, the assistant, will assist you get a copy. It will also be a good chance to come and have tea there. So, the strategic plan is entitled Laying the Groundwork for Growth and Sustainability 2018 to 2022. And this was not by accident. This was intentional. If you notice that it means, therefore, that even at 2022, we will not have reached our destination. We are just, our work is to lay the groundwork, which means all the achievements, and if we accomplish this, we would have laid the groundwork for the people coming after us, and the ones coming after and after for as long as Kijabe exists. So, in my opinion, we are laying the groundwork for the next 100 years. Just think about the people who, the founders of who came to Kenya in 1915. And that is essentially what we are doing. We are laying the groundwork for the next 100 years. So the strategic plan reads, begins by saying, we will achieve leadership in specialized. These guys are exposing me now. It's usually nice to hide behind such things that you feel. Now I have to hold this like a handbag. Now you can see me fidgeting. It's okay. We will achieve leadership of specialized surgical and medical services market through delivery of a superior healthcare service experience founded on a highly skilled Christian workforce, excellent theater facilities, a two-pronged affordable pricing, and that's compassionate and standard and process efficient. And this captures everything. And if you notice, for those of you who've been involved in various activities that have begun basically implementation of the strategy, If you think about it critically, it's always been about this. This has become the priority elements for us. And when we talk about leadership, I think we've talked about this and we've talked about this. Just think about the leaders in industry and then compare yourself to them. And you will quickly realize that while we are at a good place, we are not where we want to be. We cannot say we are a leader in industry because leaders in industry disrupt. They bring innovation, they bring processes that basically question a status quo. The status quo that we are trying to question is who said a poor, or who said the common Kenyan cannot access healthcare with dignity, you know, without the need for a long queue, at a very exorbitant price. So that is what we are disrupting. We are trying to say that a Kenyan out there, some of them your relatives or even yourself, can access healthcare without having to worry about a 10-12 month queue, and without having to worry about bankruptcy, because they can seek this solace that there is somewhere where people are constantly innovating about providing quality healthcare at the lowest cost. So, these are our pillars. Maybe I can ask, do you remember our core values? Who can tell me? Sarah? Huh? Okay, one is sustainability. Anyone else? Compassion, that one you are all singing. I don't know if it is, we shall demonstrate, practice, and talk at different things. Any other? Accountability, partly what you are doing, we are giving you all the information. And the last one? Staff engagement. Thank you. I like the order. I hope that we will also prioritize that one. So, and really, those will help us achieve our core purpose, which is to glorify God through compassionate healthcare provision, training, and spiritual ministry. This is really the essence of why Kijabe exists. And so, I'm sorry for this, that you cannot read, but basically, we will stand on six pillars. One is stewardship. Stewardship is basically that we shall do prudent financial management so that we are able to be sustainable. Superior customer experience, affordable pricing, operational excellence, stable and highly skilled workforce, leadership, and corporate governance. These are the tenets of what will help us achieve what we want to achieve. And so, looking at the quarter two, by the quarter two is April, May, June. That means that quarter three is not over. So I apologize, you shall be seeing me again next month to give the quarter three report. And I apologize for the delay in this report. It is partly because I was not around to deliver it. Goal number one is to embrace financial stewardship. This is one of the six pillars. Through adequate surplus, ensuring hospitals' viability. Now, if you look at this quarter, according to what we had budgeted last year, we've achieved 97% year to date, which means as of quarter two, we had already collected 57% of our total revenue, which was projected to be 1.36 billion. So this comes to about 7 point something billion. 0.7. And this has been driven by patient volumes from increase in traditional business lines, increase in other diversifying basically our portfolio by increasing other service lines that previously didn't exist, and efficient revenue collection. Now, I would like to give a special recognition to the finance department. Is Bernadette here? She's not here. This number may look simple, but it has been generated from a lot of hard work. And so, remember, finance department has been able to deliver to us two quarterly reports. This is very crucial because it helps us make decisions and makes us know whether we are in line with what we had planned to achieve. It takes a lot to generate these figures, especially because our current system is so erratic that a lot of work has to be done to generate these figures. So a lot of information goes to processing these figures. So makofi kwa Department of Finance. Anyone from Finance? Okay, makofi kwao. So, another good thing, like I said, efficient revenue collection has come from behavior change. And the behavior change we are talking about is itemized billing. This has been adopted very well by, we introduced itemized and point billing, I think in the at the first quarter, but it took on very well during the second quarter. And this is thanks to the billing officers and all the nurses in the hospital. So, makofi kwa all the nurses and the billing officers. Now, looking at different departments, the Naivasha inpatient number of patients seen in 2016, 79,148 and then 241. Basically, our number of inpatients in 2018 has jumped from 2017. Remember, 2017 was a year when we had the strike. So the volumes were generally higher throughout the country. Our number jumped, despite the strike, our number this year has jumped by a whopping 63%. And compared to 2016, which would be considered the baseline year, we've actually doubled our number of inpatients. Secondly, looking at number of deliveries, we used to refer many patients because we didn't have this facility. And now, our numbers jumped by a whooping 24%. In 2017, remember, 2017 was already an extraordinary year, from 106 to 131, encompassing a 24% jump. Please, let's give a hand to the Naivasha team. I think this, to me, this double digit, is it double or triple digit, whatever growth, illustrates
quadruple.
These guys are trying hard to sabotage. This is a clear illustration of when strategy and operation align and are working, and there's a synchrony between the two. What you have is impressive results. So basically, what we say this year is our revenue was supposed to grow by 25%, which informed that every operation must grow by 25% so that it is able to, this is not just about profit, it's so that we are able to sustain our ongoing activities, for example, the staffing costs, which jumped significantly. Now, these people, anything in green means that they attained that goal. You can see that inpatient and their normal delivery numbers grew significantly. The number of cesarean sections, you know, we can't. There's no comparator. Basically, we had 56 delivery cesareans, which we didn't have the year before because we did not introduce service. By the way, what is 56 divided by zero? Eh? Exactly, infinity. So, outpatient, I would like to point out the teams which managed to grow their numbers by more than 25%, because 25% is what we were targeting to be able to meet our needs. So, iClinic, Patrick, and team, anyone from I? Kuna? Aya. Physiotherapy, physiotherapy team, others, Mameni. A clap for physiotherapy team. My goodness, look at palliative. They shattered all those objectives. Anyone from palliative team? Please stand. palliative team, again, is an example of where strategy and operations combine and are syncing, because we introduced oncology service, adult oncology services, and they were able to take up these services and use it to create more volumes for themselves and this is what they deliver. Let's, anyone from ENT? Oh, they are already operating. So again, a big clap, a big hand to the ENT team. So we had an increase of 9% overall now in 2017 compared to 2018 compared to 2017, and 45% compared to what would be our normal baseline in 2016. So there are opportunities to work on, and those are the things, focus areas I would advise for these coming quarters to be looked at keenly and see what we can do differently. I'd like to also acknowledge those who nevertheless managed to grow their numbers in order to ensure that we remain afloat and are sustainable. The private services, I would like to give cognition to this centennial bed occupancy, which jumped in the second quarter to 95%. And why it is in green is because in the first quarter, we were struggling with numbers. We were even literally debating as to whether to make it another compassionate ward. But a lot of work was put into making sure the centennial bed occupancy delivered those numbers. So anyone from Centennial? Simama, Centennial? You are a one-man show. How did we achieve Pillar 1? It was through increasing traditional volumes through NHIF. We've had a very good relationship and partnership with NHIF. A lot of advertising, thanks to Salome, which we did through Inoro FM. Now I'm hearing at the event, people are asking, why Pule Daktari alikuja kwa TV is the one I want to see. So that is good. We can't complain. And streamlining of other strategic pillars, as you will notice, no pillar can work alone. So a lot of these pillars have to be tightly knit. You can't isolate one pillar and think that you'll achieve what you want to do. And then diversification. Basically, adult oncology, we began doing a lot of adult, even neurosurgery, and ENT picked up its numbers. So there was a lot of diversification as well as increasing of our traditional volumes. And this is what you will see in the trends. Like when we introduce business lines, it's not because we really want to, but also it is partly that we have to. So it is a combination of both. In theater, these are the numbers, and they experienced a growth of 3% compared to 2017, and by 13% when compared to 2016. And I think in this quarter we had not done much interventions as far as, for example, putting the Saturday list and other things, but Grace Kamau, I am watching you. So goal number two, deliver superior customer experience in every customer facing situation. This really is the goal that defines who we are, because we talk about compassion being one of our pillars. And so if this goal is struggling, basically everything, in my opinion, in the institution will struggle. So one of the ways you can think about it is timeliness. And so OPD waiting time, I'm told, dropped to 4 hours, down from our previous 6 hours. We streamlined, there was a streamlining of some of the elective patients' admission process, and bed management picked up. Quality, pressure source, for those who don't know, your neighbor can explain. I am sure there's a nurse everywhere. For total nursing care, those patients who basically cannot do anything for themselves. For example, if a patient is mentally in a coma or something like that, reduced from 22.7% to 14%. This may look like a small thing, but it means there was a lot of intentionality in as far as quality of care that was delivered. So I would like to give a big applause to all the patient assistants and the nurses that were involved in dropping these numbers. Makofi kwao. So we will wait to see it at zero. Yes. So the third, the other thing is, like, remember our mission. This pillar, it talks about our mission and one of our compassionate healthcare, and we cannot ignore the spiritual component. And in this quarter, 163 people got saved, five of these from the KCHS student lot, and many others were encouraged and prayed for or with. So a big applause to the spiritual team for achieving this. So the question I ask from this pillar is, what are we really interested in? I know Salome keeps telling me, customer care, customer care. Are we really interested in, if you look at this pillar, are we really interested in customer care training, or is it the compassionate care that we are interested in? Empathy. We are interested in looking at the other person, understanding the other person, and asking yourself, what would I do for them? Am I doing for them what I would have loved to be done to me? And now they even say, am I doing for them what they want to be done for? You know, there's that other level. So let us look at some of the markers, because at the end of the day, we can say we are delivering a very good experience. Kijabe is known for, you know, spiritual ministry, but are the numbers showing that? In January, the red is negative feedback. The blue is positive feedback. As of January, can you say that this institution exhibited compassionate care? February, the red and the blue. Can you say this institution exhibited compassionate care? March, the same. April, the same. May, the same. Because basically, it is a gamble. You are saying 50% of your patients, maybe a third of your patients are saying that they were not pleased with the service you offered. You understand? It means that a patient walking to Kijabe is gambling. They don't know there's a chance that they will get not so good care. And May, the same thing. There was a marked improvement in June, and then look at July. Understand? Now, let us look at, because it's always good to start with the positives, three top recurring positive comments was good doctor care, genuine care without exploitation. I know you know when a doctor is standing here, you think, it's rigging. It's not me, it's the customer saying, okay? And then most services, generally physiotherapy, Bethany Kids. Again, you know when I say Bethany Kids, you say, it's a pediatric surgeon. It's not me, it's the customers. This information is from Salome. Centennial Ward, ICU, Burnett, what's most positively mentioned, and then our spiritual care element. Okay? Those are the positives. Now, let's look at the negatives. Number one, rudeness, lack of courtesy, vernacular, chatting on phone, lack of eye contact, being unreasonable. These are what patients are saying. You know, we can laugh about it, but it's a serious issue. This, can you be trained about this? You cannot be trained. We can deliver all the customer care training that you want, because I see a lot of papers which, you know, we need customer care training. We need customer care training. Can I teach you how to be less rude? You decide to be less rude, right? It's in you. So, you know, this is bad. This just simply looks bad. Especially if we say one of our core values is compassion. And then if we say that we are a Christian hospital. You know, this is just plain bad. I will not put it in any other way. Long turnaround time, records, lab cashier, points, insurance, and pharmacy. I know Chris has been working hard on it, but again, as long as customers are saying, we have not reached a happy place. So we must put more effort. We must keep putting effort until these complaints stop appearing. Long admission and theater scheduling process. We can say we have generated as much revenue as we want. We can talk about how many surgeries we do. But until we stop giving patients a waiting time of 6-7 months, we have not reached where we want to be. We are not at a happy place. Communication breakdown. This may even tie with some of these things. You see here, vernacular, chatting on phone, lack of eye contact. These are all maybe one thing. And then housekeeping concerns, that's cleanliness, OPD, toilets, benches, and hand stamping. Hand stamping is another, I think, should be a separate component. So we'll be looking at all these things, because right now what we are saying, we have to be customer-centric. We must be patient-centric. It must be, at the end of the day, about the patient. So when I ask you, how is your department doing? Oh, we are better. I don't care about better until these things have gone. So we are now going towards a metric-driven result, not an emotional, you know, you say, I feel better, I feel nice, okay? We must see results. We must see results because also we have put in so much. A lot of the fillers, for example, staff engagement is about inputs. Those are our inputs, inputs. How much things have you put in? All the machines we've put in, but what we need is an output. The output is about the customer. So number three is affordable pricing in line with our compassionate care. I'm sorry. So in this month, in this quarter, we delivered uncompensated care amounting to 38.7 million. About 28 million or 72.6 of it being NHIF maternity charges not recovered from NHIF. This is because there's a cost differential. For every, cesarean that is done, our cost, we do not meet our cost. The other thing is that 23%, 8.7 million being directed towards debt write-off for unsecured debt. Basically, what this means is that there are many patients, or 8.7 million is service that we delivered, but we didn't charge. Now, this may look bad, but on the other hand, this is just saying that we are actually living up to the compassionate pillar. So anyone who is questioning that, there's a metric that we can demonstrate that. So we'd like to acknowledge our international, basically various partners that have helped us chip into the needy fund and mobilization. This is WATSI, Friends of Kijabe, people like the Smile Train and even the Bethany Kids Foundation. And the local partners like Safaricom Foundation, which donated some equipment, Madison Insurance, amongst other partners. Number four is achieve operational excellence to deliver on speed and efficiency. Basically, the strategic plan is very intentional about if you are going to offer low cost, you must deliver. Low cost cannot go with low volumes. Low cost equals high volumes, which means you must deliver on speed and efficiency. So with this, and some of this comes from streamlining, everyone understanding what they are doing. So in this quarter, we completed at least 7 protocols and SOPs. I think everyone here has signed a job description. If not, there is a job description available for you to sign. We are geared up towards finally getting an automated services. We've already selected hospital management information system through a competitive and inclusive process. The aim is that one day we will be able to go, you know, from a visual perspective, paperless. But really, the solution is not paperless. The solution is that so that the hospital is able to communicate better, that a patient can walk to the lab, and by the time they arrive the lab, their test has already been ordered, and the lab people know way in advance. That a patient who is coming for admission today does not need to come and report, and then people realize that this patient is actually admitted, is supposed to be admitted for an elective surgery. That by the time they arrive, the system has already identified them, and a bed is prepared for them, and everything is prepared for them, so that we streamline those processes for them. Just think about it in the banking sector. Before automation, you would go to a bank and you would withdraw some money. And this would not be registered in other branches, right? And they had to send these hard copies. And so it would take like 7 days before you could do another deposit or withdrawal, because they had to recall and sign all the accounts throughout the country. So, and then technology came and that all changed. And now you can go to an ATM and withdraw money, and it quickly synchronizes throughout all the branches in the country. Actually, you could withdraw money from even another country, and your bank, it reconciles to their bank account. That is what we are trying to achieve, but from a medical perspective. We are trying to synchronize systems so that we can deliver a good experience to our patients. Now, this will cost us, because you need to know this, this will cost us 14 million shillings. So it is not cheap, but it is necessary, because once at its optimal, when functioning optimally, you can achieve, they say, 30% growth in your output just from putting a good system. Networks upgrade, you will see a lot of wiring that is happening, because you need a very efficient, you need very efficient internet to be able to deliver on a good HMIS system. Otherwise, it will be like driving a Ferrari on a road that has potholes. You can have a very good performance car, but you need a good road to be able to streamline your processes. Goal number five is develop and retain a highly skilled workforce to deliver on the hospital's mission. So for the nurses and clinical officers, I think we've done the second phase of streamlining compensation. And also, we are at the point where for some, we are signing what we call senior staff contracts. For others, we've employed, I think we've finally given, when I came to office, there was a lot of complaints about casual laborers being there for a very long time. We have finally put them on contract now. About 134 casual laborers have been in contract. Is this a rumor or true? How many got those contracts? Any casuals? Yes. Is it? So it is true. I'm not saying my own things. And then we began transport. We apologize that it's been erratic because you have one bus, but we'll be thinking of a better solution and bringing alternative ways of ensuring that we constantly provide this. We've streamlined this uniform acquisition process. Again, the reason for this is because there was a long lead time for the for acquisition of uniforms, and so we've outsourced the service, not because we don't want the service in-house, but because one, we wanted the branded uniforms, and two, it is because when we did the culture audit, one of the biggest complaints was that you work for Kijabe, you will take more than a year to get your uniform. True or false? Yes, so that is the reason why we did. We've done, for those people who go out on various activities, we've done a revision of the lunch allowance, because I know that that was also a big complaint, that the lunch allowance that was being given was not in line with the current cost of living. Sasa Kwanza, maybe even next month you'll be coming back and saying it is now 16% up. Negotiations are ongoing with Kudeya. Just like Ndivo asked, what is the definition of Kudeya? Who can tell us? So that everyone can know. Eh? One member can tell us. Yeah. Kudeya member? No one? Si ta sœur va. You don't want. Okay, ça va. And then I know that I've just received a letter from Canaan to begin the second the negotiations for the coming years. So what we've done for the other cadres, like the doctors, is streamline the doctor engagement policy. Basically, what we've done is scrap off part-time, and we've developed a different model. Because now we are saying, if you are in, we want you in. A streamlining of the private practice policy so that the benefits can ripple across. And that is why we are now able to do these salary adjustments, for example, after the negotiations with the various unions. Missionary engagement policy, we realize that missionaries is a critical partner, and it would be important to come up with a policy, an onboarding policy, and so that when missionaries come to Kijabe, their expectations match reality. We are able to bridge that gap. And thank you to Dr. Ariana. She has agreed to champion that in line in consultation with our HR team and the office of the CEO. We've streamlined the housing policy. I know this is especially has been a big battle, and it's painful. But like I say, I really apologize for the inconvenience. But it is necessary we do this because of our projections of growth, of needs, continued demand. So the policy that we put in place is transparent. And we formed an appeals committee in order to humanize those people who will be affected. Then for spiritual, because remember, this pillar talks about staff engagement in order to achieve the mission. The mission is excellent healthcare, spiritual ministry, education for healthcare, for God's glory, right? And so spiritual ministry is one of the pillars of that whatever. And so this season, in that quarter, the season two of Mizizi Discipleship Week runs for 10 weeks, happened, and 19 staff managed to partake of that. 33 staff took the Ombi discipleship sessions, and 9 students are doing a 9-lesson discipleship program, who are doing the gospel-centered life. For goal number 6, to strengthen hospital leadership and corporate governance, we've now developed what we call, we did it last week, what we call metrics approach to clinical care, where we look at metrics to determine whether we are doing health, we are doing well or badly. You know, just the same way you don't say, oh, we are doing well financially. You actually show it through the figures. And about to start the phase 2 of culture change, which will involve leadership training, performance management, and continuous quality improvement projects that we take. So for infrastructure, we will be starting the palliative building construction phase 2 anytime now. We have hired a new project manager. I don't know if he's here or he started on a bad footing. Raymond, he's forgotten, he's still on probation. And then theater designs almost complete, because we plan to expand theater so that we are able to address those 9-month waiting lists, 12-month waiting lists, along with additional staff. So I think, how many theaters are going to be added?
Added, well, to get to 15 total.
Okay, to get to 15 total. Oxygen plant audit is ongoing, and the aim is that this is the current biggest limitation of any growth in the hospital. You know, without oxygen, we can't serve. We can't have critical patients. Basically, we can't have an inpatient bed without oxygen. And then electricity audit was complete, and there's a plan by December to change all lights to LED so that we are able to save on the cost of electricity. And we shall be looking at various forms of green energy, because as we are currently, we are very exposed. We don't meet the regulatory requirements, which are that we need to, when you have a certain amount of, your consumption is above a certain amount of liters of water or something like that, you're supposed to install various green energy solutions. So what are our opportunities that we look for quarter three and four is the private. You notice that we had a lot of friends. We'll be looking at private Nairobi Clinic and KH, especially private, to deliver on some of the numbers so that again, we could, so that we don't have to constrain our compassionate healthcare patients. We hope to work on our delightful customer experience pillar. Because as you have seen, there are too many reds, and it is it's literally a paradox. It is we are in a diabolical state where we are saying that we are a compassionate healthcare, but the customers don't agree with you. Automation, I think we'll start implementation anytime in this quarter. And then clinical policy improvement, really, this is about saying, are we helping our patients? So that are we preventing death in the best way, in the most predictable way, in a way that can be replicated by others? Are we also preventing morbidity or harm to them and improving, improving health? So thank you very much. I would like to end by reading this letter. It is not so, I'll read it for you because I know you may not see properly. So this is one of our patients, and it is no secret because she signed off there, and it's a public letter. It is Jennifer Naikuni, who is the daughter of, actually the patient that we admitted. And she's the mother of Naikuni. She was admitted in the Barnett ward. And her letter goes like this. Thanksgiving, Ephesians 5:20. In the name of God, the Father, God and Son, Jesus Christ and Holy Spirit, shalom and greetings. Thanks to our Most High God, I take this opportunity to thank our Ebenezer this far for the love at Kijabe Hospital on behalf of Naikuni's family and our mother, Eda Naikuni, basically. I may need to read it from my phone. Yeah, so please accept. Thanks to our Most High, Eda Naisonoi Naulone, patient number X, private ward 5, room 5, where she was admitted on 10th July 2018. We came very wounded, worried, and confused, but encountered the healing. Love of our God. Indeed, this is heaven's headquarter. Please appreciate my gratitude on behalf of our mama. I thank each department we've encountered. The day we arrived to the director's office, we experienced a very big elephant's heart of love through Pamela and business office. Security received us by giving us a smile and bringing the wheelchair. The nurses at the private ward, Sister Margaret, Pauline, if I mention your name, you may stand. Sister Margaret, Pauline, Jerry, Lydia, Sylvia, Sadera, Josephine, Priska, Kibet, Joanne, and the entire nursing fraternity, we appreciate your service. Coming to sanitation, Grace, Priska, Rono, Naomi, Salome and the entire laundry team, bravo. The catering team, Brother Dan, Ian, Liz, and the list of endless. At theater, Dr. Thumba, Kelly, Dr. Evelyn, Bugwa, Suleiman, and Emily. I don't know what Evelyn was doing in theater. Asante sana. The God of heaven will reward you. Another team I can't forget to glorify for is chaplaincy led by Reverend Divo, Pastor Benjamin, Sospita Masharia, local church and shopping center. We were very warmly welcomed. Thank you all. Kijabe is the place like heaven on earth. I vote to come and visit and pray for healing for the sick. 1,000,000,000 thanks is never enough once again. God bless you. Yours faithfully, Jennifer Naikuni. I shall not rest until 100% of our patients can give such comments. So those reds need to be converted into such comments. This may look like a joke, but it's a very serious affair. Let us put our efforts, let us work on the compassion care pillar so that we are able to deliver that. Because after all, that is, in another way, that is the only way we will keep getting patients. Asante sana, and I look forward to having a chat with you again at the end of quarter 3.